Hello there, I'm Sandy Allnock with this month's Create in Color for MFT stamps. And today I'm going to use one of the new stamps from Stacy Yakula. I love her little animals and this little guy flying through the air. I thought would be really fun. I could show you how to make him look like he's spinning around. I've stamped him onto watercolor paper and I also stamped the balloon. There's a package on the bottom of the balloon in the stamp, but I just masked that out so he could be holding it. And I stamped the little guy at an angle. So that's going to make him look like he's sort of tipped in the air. But the balloon string, it helps if you make that vertical so that it just looks like the balloon is still going straight up. Or else it would look like a windier day if you put him at an angle. For my background, I decided to just play. I wanted to see what would happen with a couple of my greens and blues if I just let them mix on the paper. So I painted the whole thing with a light coat of water first, and that's going to help all the colors to mix. As long as I don't get too puddly, just nice and wet, but keep applying all different colors. I'm trying my electric blue, my cobalt teal blue, a little bit of serpentine green, a little bit of sap green, just to make some fun color in the sky and let it just be a playful background. It's a great way with your own watercolors to test them out and see what looks good together. You might find that there's some colors that blend together nicely. You can drop in another color and it'll all of a sudden push out some other colors for no reason. Like this nickel azo is a really fun color and I was thinking it would be really cool in here because it tends to explode into other colors, but it started looking a little strange. So, you know, I learned from that. I learned that this is not maybe necessarily the best use for that color and I'll use it in different ways. And I'll just mix some other colors in along with it. Throw in a little sap green and just play. And you can keep working something like this as long as you keep those edges nice and wet. They're going to continue to blend. As soon as it gets dry, though, you may get some hard edges or you might not be able to work one color into another. But if you keep things moving, then you can get a really interesting, fun background. Remember that watercolor is always going to dry lighter than you expect. So I'm trying to put a lot of color in here because I want a fairly rich color in here. Not a ton, but fairly rich. If there's blobs of color, like I had some color right around him that seemed a little darker than I wanted, just dab it off using a little baby wipe, that sort of thing. And then I wanted to do a little texture to it as well. So just before it was completely dry and it kind of loses its sheen, but it's still damp, I spritzed it. And you can see I got some little water splotchy texture on it, which was kind of fun. I waited for all that to completely dry so then I could paint the mouse. And one of the cool things about this background technique is that I painted all of it so that I knew the mouse was going to be darker than the colors in my background. And if I splooched over with my background, it didn't matter if I covered his little hand or his feet or something with a little bit of that blue or green, because I'm going to make him a dark grayish and dark brownish kind of color. So I thought that that would compensate nicely in case I did any splooging. It's usually more helpful to do your background first on something like this if you're doing a full background, because if you mess that up, then you haven't wasted all your time painting your little image. But also, if I start painting all of that blue and green color and there's a little tiny bit of that brown color from my mouse that's still wet, it might start to bleed out into the actual background. So it's more helpful sometimes to work the opposite direction, paint the background first, and then work on the little mouse. But I've left his glasses blank for right now because what I want to do is add a little bit of the color of the mouse in there. So when you're doing glasses, if you can make it a lighter shade of whatever is underneath of it. So if it's a person, do a lighter skin tone. With the mouse, I want to use lighter browns and grays to create that. But I want it to dry a little bit first, so I left his glasses blank until the rest of the paint had dried at least a little bit, so I didn't have too much color just suddenly bleeding into his glasses. Don't ask me how I know that if you don't wait long enough, you will have color bleeding in places that you don't want it to bleed. That is kind of the hallmark of my painting style, is not waiting long enough and having all kinds of messes happen that have to be fixed. lots of things can be avoided by just waiting for it to dry. So I'm going to add a little bit of color to the rest of these things while I also say a hearty thank you, especially to those who left messages on my last video when I talked about going to Eustis for teaching at MFT later on this summer. I can't wait to meet you guys. And it was nice to see some names of people that I have seen around the universe of the internet, and knowing that you're going to be coming to my class. And we'll be doing some Copic coloring while we're there. Hopefully we'll do some live streaming so everybody else can have some fun too. I would like to kind of do something like that. We'll see how that works out when I get there. Don't know what the schedule will look like, etc. But I will at least send you greetings from down there, because I would like to share a little bit with everybody as well. Finishing off my image, just putting a little color in the balloon, a little bit more in the hat. And now I want to show you how to make him look like he's spinning in the air, because he really does look like he's spinning around. So I'm going to take a micron pen, and if you're doing this as your last step, you can do it with a Sharpie or any kind of black pen, as long as you're not going to be painting over top of it. And I'm going to make some half circles and then one little kind of spiral toward the bottom, and a few little marks around the ears and around the balloon make those look like they're moving as well. Just a few lines like this can add motion to it. That's really fun. I've already added my card now onto the base, and with another paper layer behind it. And my finishing step is to add some glossy accents in the glasses, in the balloon. And then I thought it would also be fun to make some little bubbles around him, so he's got a little bit more going on. And I have some ribbon on the bottom. Oh my goodness, such cuteness. I am so excited that Stacy is making stamps for MFT, because I could never color enough of them. They're so cute. Well, I will see you guys again next month. It's always fun to come and visit over here at MFT. And I will see some of you over on my YouTube channel at some point, and in classes as well on my teaching site. So check you guys out later. Have a great February. Bye-bye.